Alright, this fool, if he keeps on freaking messaging me like that, yo, I mean, like, for real, okay, dog? There's no money that I owe you. If you didn't give that money to your partner who worked with you, I think it was 150. Text message, you can bring the equipment that you've had for. That has yet to happen. We get paid every 2 weeks. Stop. Well, I realize that might convey the message a little clearer if the audio actually records. So disregard that first one. Listen, okay? You and your partner worked 2 days, and rather than paying you every 2 weeks, like I told you is commonplace and practice for us, you asked to be paid every day. I told you I'm going to take the service fee for that out of the pay. And so, I mean, it adds up quite a bit. Like, I'll send $200 and it's $6.50 to do that, okay? So, essentially, the first day I sent you $121, I think. $122, okay? It says $117, but the service fee. So, $122 the first day. Next day, I sent you $100 and something else. And then I saw that, oh, there was a discrepancy. It was an hour, not a half an hour. So I paid you for the other half an hour that wasn't there. And if that's wrong, still. So that was another payment I sent you even like yesterday, last night. It's like $22 again, $22.50, I think, something like that, minus the service fee. And if that's not, you know, like if it doesn't add up, I asked you to bring the equipment back to work that you've had for over a week. And we can discuss it, but, you know, cussing me out in text message is not going to do what you want it to. At least I don't believe what you're trying to accomplish is piss me off to the point where I don't want to work with you anymore. It's already been extremely inconvenient. I feel like I have definitely went over and above accommodating you, and you're a good worker. You know what you're doing. Just seem to be not quite stable enough to depend on, and that is a real issue. And then secondary, if not actually more important, is the fact that there's been financial dispute after financial dispute. It's like you disappeared for a week and you were overpaid $100 advance. I didn't hear from you for 4 days. You said your phone broke, okay, but then even then, it's like you come back to work and what you didn't think I was going to take that money out of your pay. It's like, come on, dude. If I was you, I would have maybe asked me about it at the very least, but you didn't. And, you know, I did tell you, by the way, in person, I told you, look, I'm taking $50 out and then $50 out. So it's not $100 at once. I told you that when I gave you the food that day, when you asked if I had any food and I got back there at 4:45. And then I gave you guys that food and told you, hey, I'm taking the other $50 out. So that was $100. So we added together and the total payments, $270-something. Then you add the 100, that's 370-something. That means that as far as my record shows, we're square. Now, if you didn't pay your partner $151 or $153 like you should have, that's not on me, because there was the equivalent of $370-some-odd Okay. So it's not bad business practice on my part. It's just really poor behavior on yours. Like, son of a what son of a Sam? It's damn Cam on Catamaran Lane. I'm here in the Hove, man. You know what I'm saying? It's like.